Oh, it's yourself, Andy. Andy, come away in, sit down, grab a pew. Right, what would you like to discuss this week, Andy?
Well, a game came out a couple of weeks ago called Battlefield 1. I don't know if any of the listeners have heard of it. Well, for the last couple of weeks for it to settle in and test out the game to what we feel as the capacity that we can give a proper, honest review on it.
Mm-hmm.
So, I'll ask you the question. What do you like about it? Is there anything you specifically really like about it?
I like the fact that it's World War One, and there's no jumping about all the rest of it. It's your bog standard gun, enemy, shoot 'em, and objectives, and it's all about the W. It's not about the kill death ratio, because in Battlefield One, as you know, you die a shitload amount of times. You get one kill, maybe two or three if you're really lucky, and then you get killed. What about yourself?
So, personally, the thing that really I fucking love about it is the whole operations mode.
Mm-hmm.
It's online multiplayer, and it's your wee squad of five, and obviously a big massive team, 64 players, 32 a side, and you're either defending or attacking points. And if you're attacking points, you need to take like two objectives on that point. Two landmarks, then you move on to the next one, and there's five of these bits. Once you successfully take all of them, you move on to another map. Although there's only two maps.
Yeah,
but it is a bit lacking on that side of things. There's only like four maps to choose for total. If they made that bigger, that would be fucking amazing. And that would make my day.
I'm sure DICE have got something along up their sleeves, whereas they'll release some DLC with more maps for operations. I can probably guarantee that 100%. So, Andy, is there any bad points for Battlefield 1 that you would like to get off your chest?
Bad points. This here is a very bad point. I hate it, and it is so frustrating. At times,
all right.
The whole Battlefield party join thing is an absolute farce. I don't know why they couldn't have kept it the way it was on Battlefield 4, when you one player in the squad launched a party and you invited the players. This one, I don't know what's going on. If you've got a party of four or five and one person's in playing and another person jumps into another game, it comes up on the screen as big as bold. There's another game to join, and if you're in the middle of doing something and you accidentally press X, it takes you out of that game and flings you straight in another game.
Right.
That frustrates me, and I'm pretty sure there's more people around the world that it'll frustrate as well.
Mm-hmm. You're absolutely bang on there. I don't know why they just didn't stick with what they had in Battlefield 4. Before the game kicks off, you make a squad, and that's you, or you batter in. The squad leader takes control and picks a server, and that's you away and rocking and rolling.
Yep. So, what about yourself? I'm pretty sure you've got some bad points about Battlefield as well. It's not always good.
It's very true. Well, the only major arc I had was the amount of camping and we arseholes that weren't actually playing the fucking objective. And we're more interested in their kill death ratio, which is insignificant in a field, a battlefield. It's all about the win, it's all about playing as a team, it's all about doing the objective. It's no about, look at me, I just went fucking 50 for one. Aye, very good, you dick, but we actually fucking didn't win the game because you're sitting in a fucking barn camping with your sniper rifle, you wee fucking tadger. So, luckily, COD come out this week, this Friday, so all the wee guys are probably all the way back to sit in camp in COD and play team deathmatch in COD and get a nice wee kill death ratio and get a nuke or whatever the fuck it is, which is fine. If that's a game for them, then that's fine.
Right, so is there anything that's going to be happening or anything you think is going to be happening in Battlefield over the coming month?
Well, through the grapevine and what I've heard through various social media sites that I've visited, that in this month, in November, we're due an update, and what that update's going to do is, it's all to do with squad leaders. You know yourself, when you're playing Battlefield, you've got certain objectives, maybe it's A, B, C, D, E, Z, fucking D, whatever, you need to go and capture. And we go and we do the capturing, we're not sitting camping, we're actually doing the objective. However, the squad leader isn't sending us orders. He's not telling us, right guys, let's go and get Apples, let's go and get Charlie.
And then he, you mean Bushy?
Or whoever. Right, so...
Or Presters.
Basically, anybody except us. So, they're not dishing out the orders, because when you dish out an order, you get more points, and if I'm squad leader or you're squad leader and you dish out an order, right guys, let's go get Apples, the entire squad tends to, apart from Bushy, go and get Apples. So, yes, we're all working together as a team. One's a support class, one's a medic, one's an assault, Bushy's a sniper up in the hill, and the three of us are working together, and Bushy's kind of support, providing cover. So if I get down, I could get revived for the medic, or you can blow up a tank because you're assault. However, the amount of times we've played a game and not one, apart from us, has dished out an order, that'll change, because when you're playing as a squad member, you can request an order, and then within a certain time, whether it be 30 seconds, a minute, whatever, if they don't give you an order, they'll be removed as squad leader, and that squad member that asked for the order will become squad leader, which I think that's a vast improvement. That's something they should have brought in from the very start.
That does sound like something they should have brought in from the start, and I completely agree with you. The amount of times that we play the game and somebody else is the squad leader and don't set the waypoints, we like to, for 3 points here, we like to be as a team, go like, let's go to A, let's go to B, let's go to C. We like to have that bit of teamwork within our squad.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to join the squad, folks, you know what gamer tags me now, Andy 1868 and Bremer 72.
Yep.
Hit us up on the PSN. Is there anything else that's happening in Battlefield this month?
Well, I've also heard a wee rumour, I don't know, and I can't confirm nothing, but I think we're going to get some Russian DLC. As you know, the Germans, the Austrians, the English, sorry, the British, are involved in Battlefield 1, and I think the Russians are going to be coming in soon, so that's something else to good. And that'll maybe also open up the map a bit and give us some more maps, as in a wee bit more eastern towards Europe. So that's something to look forward to, I reckon.
Yep. Going to battle for Mother Russia.
Yes, yes.
Ooh.
Where the fuck are you going? Sit down, we're not finished yet. So that's Battlefield 1 pretty much wrapped up. Andy, would you like to get a wee score out of 10? What you think?
Well, I thought long and hard about this, the score out of 10, and I think I'm going to give it a 7.
Alright.
Only because, well, they could be doing me main maps on operations. I've made that point clear.
Mm-hmm.
And obviously, they could do so much more potential in this game than what it's showing at the moment. They might be fixing that with DLC in the future. Fingers crossed for me, for you and the viewers, they do that. But that was what I'm giving out of 10. What about yourself?
Well, I'm going to be slightly more generous and give it an 8 out of 10. Pretty much for the exact same reasons you've just gave. The lack of maps. There's plenty there to be going on with, but another couple of months of the maps and it'll be pretty much, we'll be pulling our hair out looking for new maps. And also the lack of customization. I do like putting daft stuff on guns and stuff like that, and I don't want to be buying battle packs and all that shite. But it's dice only go down that road, but I would rather there's a bit more customization.
Another point as well, I just want to flung you end here. What do you think about the guns? Do you think there's enough guns in the game? I don't think there is. I know it's World War I in that, but
I've got a funny feeling. Aye. I've got a funny feeling, like you touched on earlier, I think the DLC will bring an absolute shitload more guns. I can pretty much guarantee we will get more guns with upcoming DLC. Right, Andy, right viewers, that pretty much wraps up Battlefield 1 with an overall score from Andy of 7 out of 10 and from myself, Bremer, 8 out of 10. And what we'll do is, next week, you can tune in, and I don't actually have the games, but my man here, Andy, does, and he'll be reviewing for us Infinite Warfare and Call of Duty Remastered Modern Warfare.
Oh, and don't forget to tune in to the Twitch channel, TTSC1. Don't forget also Twitter, at TTSC1, and of course, the good old Facebook channel,
Scotland's TTSC.